Thank you for joining this CSBOT video about DINOv2, a new computer vision model for Meta AI that claims to finally provide a foundational model in computer vision, closing some of the gap from natural language processing, where it is already common for a while now. In this video, we'll talk about what does it mean a foundational model in computer vision, and why DINOv2 can count as such. DINOv2 is a huge model, with 1 billion params. So this comes with hard challenges, both for training the model and using it. We'll talk about some of the challenges and what Meta AI has done in order to overcome these challenges using self-supervision and distillation. Don't worry if you are not familiar with these terms, we'll explain them when we'll get there. Let's start by first understanding what DINOv2 provides that make it a foundational model in computer vision. In the life before a foundational model, one would need to find or create a dataset, choose some architecture for a model, and train the model on the dataset. The model you need may be complex and may require a long or hard training. So here comes DINOv2, a pretrained huge visual transformer model, which is known architecture in the field of computer vision, and says that you may not need a robust, complex, dedicated model. Say for example that we have a cat image. We can provide this image as an input to DINOv2. DINOv2 will yield a vector of numbers, often called embeddings or visual features. These embeddings contain deep understanding of the input cat image, and once we have them, we can use them in smaller, simpler models that handle specific tasks. For example, we can have one model that should handle semantic segmentation, which means categorizing related parts in the image, and one model to estimate the depth of the objects in the picture. The output examples here are taken from Meta AI demo for using DINOv2. Another very important attribute for DINOv2 here is that while training these task-specific models, DINOv2 can be frozen, or in other words, no fine-tuning is needed, which further simplifies the training of the simpler models and their usage. Since DINOv2 can be executed on an image once, and the output can be used by multiple models. Unlike if it was fine-tuned, then there was a need to run the fine-tuned DINOv2 version for any task-specific model we have. Also, fine-tuning such a huge model is not trivial to do and requires proper hardware that is not accessible to everyone. Let's discuss shortly about how to use DINOv2. If you would want to use DINOv2, then you could simply load it using PyTorch code, like we do here. We see that there are few possible versions to load, so you can decide which version to use based on your needs and resources. The accuracy does not significantly drop when using a smaller version, which is cool, especially if using one of the middle-sized versions. This brings us to talk about how they generated the different types of models, and the answer is distillation. Distillation means transferring knowledge from a large trained model into a new, smaller model. An interesting note is that while doing so, they got better results than trying to learn smaller models directly. The way it is being done is taking the large pre-trained DINOv2 model and use it to teach new smaller models. So, for example, given a cat image, DINOv2 yields some embeddings. Then, we have a smaller model, which we also feed with the same cat image. And it also yields embeddings. The distillation process will try to minimize the difference between the embeddings coming from the new model to the one coming from DINOv2. Remember, we keep DINOv2 frozen here, so only the right side is changing. This method is often called teacher-student distillation, since the left side here acts as a teacher, while the right one acts as a student. In practice, they did not use just one student, but rather multiple ones, and each simultaneously gets the same inputs and yield results. During training, an average of all of the student models is created, which ends up to be the final graduated distilled model. Before moving on, if you'd like to stay on track with similar advancements in AI, please subscribe to the channel and hit the like button to support the creation of more similar content. With DINOv2, the model size was increased dramatically from previous DINO version, which raised the need for more training data. This brings us to talk about self-supervised learning with large curated data. So first, what is self-supervised learning? In short, it means our training data has no labels, and the model learns solely from the images. the first DINO version also used self-supervised learning techniques. Okay, so without data labeling, it should be easier to increase training data size. However, previous attempts to increase uncurated data size with self-supervised learning have caused a drop in quality. With DINOv2, they built an automated pipeline to create a curated dataset, which helped them to reach state-of-the-art results comparing to other self-supervised learning models. They started with 25 sources of data that combined had 1.2 billion images and extracted 142 million images out of it. So, this pipeline has multiple filtering steps. For example, in the original uncurated dataset, we're likely to find a lot of cat images, and also some other images. Training on such data as is may lead to a model that is very good in understanding cats, but may not do very good in generalizing to other domains. So one of the steps in this pipeline was to use clustering, which basically means grouping images based on similarities. Then they could sample from each group a similar amount of images and were able to create a smaller but more diverse dataset. Another benefit for using self-supervised learning is better pixel-level understanding. A common approach in computer vision nowadays is using text-guided pretraining. For example, this cat image would come with a description text that may be similar to a white kitten in a field of grass. Both the image and the text are provided as input to such a model. However, the description text may miss data, such as that the cat is walking, or the small white flowers. So this may lead to limiting the learning capability. With DINOv2, with self-supervised learning, they showed that the model has amazing capability to learn pixel-level information. As an example here, we can see multiple horse images. And when visualizing the result of DINOv2 on them, we can see that horses in different pictures get similar colors for same body parts, even if there are multiple horses in a picture, and even if they are super tiny, very impressive. Thank you for watching and taking the time to learn about DINOv2. Please let me know in the comments section what do you think about DINOv2.